people say AI are a super intellectual species, but let's think about that in a slightly different way. Let's say you're on a computer. You get a message saying, "Do you want $200,000? Just press OK." And you press OK. Less than a minute later, your computer shuts down. You've just had a realization that that message was a virus. 2 days later, you're on a computer once more. You get a similar message, except it says $1 million now. What would you do? You'd most likely press cancel, right? Like, there's no way you're gonna accept that money because your computer's gonna shut down again. But what would AI do? They might still press OK because they don't really make actions based off of previous experiences. So, I know what some of you are wondering right now. What is AI and when did it start? It started when we started using wires, chips, and all that kind of things. And also, AI is the worst at handling emotions. Like, we all are worst at something, right? So if you want an AI to tell the truth about something, it will tell the truth at many occasions. A situation like that would be this. A robot walks by a fat man and says, "Hi, you're fat. Better get some exercise and a good diet." But no one would do that. Because they would know it would hurt the other man's feelings and be very, very rude. Okay, but not all robots are like that, okay? Not all robots. Some are not even robots. Like Siri, for example. Siri is considered as AI. Siri can search the weather, look at the map, and even take you on one of the apps. Robots and Siri are all considered as AI. In the present day, AI might be considered as very advanced. But what does this stand for? It stands for AI, artificial intelligence. Artificial means created by humans. It's not natural. Intelligence means being brilliant and smart. So basically, AI means intelligence created by humans. Now, in the present day, AI might be considered as very advanced, but that doesn't mean there couldn't be a huge breakthrough. Like, maybe robots are gonna, like, be as tall as, like, the Willis Tower or something. Okay, but what can they do? They will take over jobs, such as cleaning the street, making a bathroom look elegant, engineering buildings and other designs, because they will have more arms, internal calculators to be super exact, and all those kind of things, and therefore will save a lot of time and trouble. They might also be overpowering humans. Yeah, just like that. They might overpower humans and control the streets and all those kinds of things. Now, humans won't be alive, maybe, but maybe they still will. Maybe they'll just like be not like as good jobs anymore. They won't have job possibilities such as cleaning the street or making the bathroom look elegant. That means that they will not have jobs, they will not have money, meaning that they will live a poor life, and no one even wants that. AI will also be all kinds of people at sports. Maybe they're already helping us at homework already. Hey, what's 2 + 2? 5? I don't know, my robot helped me. And if you don't know that, then what's the point of AI? That's why they will overpower humans, for example. Like, seriously. You won't know what 2 + 2 is. That's not gonna happen though, of course. I know that. It's not gonna happen.
I mean,
so anyway, AI might just overpower humans, and humans aren't gonna be as good, have as good jobs as them. Like, well, they will still take over jobs because AI is, some things AI are just as good as humans too, though. Think about Thomas Edison. We have to be like him, failing 1,000 times. We don't just give up. We keep on going, and he made a light bulb. But why will AI overpower humans? That's because they are just so accomplished at things that we just aren't. Things are just calculating. Think about how many occasions you picked up a calculator because a problem was too complicated or simply too long. What's 2 × 2 + 5 × 4 × 5 × 100 √99? No, you're gonna pick up a calculator and do it. But still, humans like this one. That's the inside of a calculator. What? And there will be a lot of coding like that for AI. But AI doesn't possess the power of five senses. They can see, they can hear, but none of them can really smell or taste. But they are still really good at things that humans aren't, like AI beat the world champion, a chess engine, like Stockfish, for example. Like Stockfish, for example. This is a chess engine that is one of the best in the world, and one chess computer just completely obliterated it, meaning it beat it in a chess game by self-training itself for 4 hours. Well, let's talk about humans, okay? Humans, they possess the power of the five senses, and AI can do three senses, but they can't really smell or taste. AI also can't know when something is too close, and they won't really back off when a needle comes close to it. Humans are also very flexible. They are independent, and they know how to change your plan in a matter of seconds. Plan A doesn't work, let's go to plan B. Plan B doesn't work, let's go to plan C. Plan C doesn't work, and so on. Maybe AI just can't do that, and they also can't do this either. But maybe they just will overpower humans, and humans won't get good jobs, and they will look at AI as if they are some big power like God. And that wouldn't be good. Think about that. Wouldn't it be better if we were the ones that were like God, and AI were just something like as small as an insect that we use to help us do small things and sometimes important things? How about that? Let's change the way we think and learn and be more than just the human, just humans with the potential to change the world. Let's be humans with more than the potential to change the world.